everyone, welcome back to Pep Coding. So the question which we are going to solve today is known as sprint stair paths, and we will solve this in Python. So first let us understand the question and then we'll head over to the solution. You have been told that you have certain number of stairs. Let's say we have 4. Okay, we are standing on the top of the 4th stair and we need to reach the 0th stair. Okay, that is the bottom. So we have either 1 jumps, 2 jumps or 3 jumps. That is, at a time I can either take 1 jump or 2 jumps or 3 jumps. So if I take 1 jump, then I can take 3 jump directly. That is one possibility. Then I can take 1 jump, then 2 jumps and then 1 jump. So 1, 2, 1 will also be a possibility. I can also take 1, 1 and 2 jumps. And I can also take 1 jump continuously. 1, 1, 1 and 1. Right. Similarly, I can take 2 jumps first. Right. I can take 2 jumps, then 2 jumps. I can take 2 jumps, then 1 jump, then 1 jump. Right. I can also take 3 jumps directly and then 1 jump. I can take 4 jumps directly. Can I? No. We can only take 1, 2 and 3 jumps at a time. Okay. You cannot take 4 jumps. So these are some of the possible ways to go from the 4th stair to the bottom, that is to the 0th level. Right. So that is what you have to print. All the possible ways in which you will reach the ground or the 0th stair from the stair which has been assigned to you. That is, for example, if I'm starting from 3, so I can either go 1, 2 or 3 steps. So if I go 1 step, I'll remain with 2. If I go 2 steps, I'll have 1 remaining. And if I go 3 steps, I'll have 0 remaining. What will be the path? From here 1, from here 2, from here 3. And this is an answer for us. Again, from 2, I can go 1, 2, 3. From here also I can go 1, 2 and 3. From here I don't need to go, right? So I'll end over here only. So from here, for if I take 1 step, 1. If I take 2 steps, 0. If I take 3 steps, minus 1. This is not going to give a wrong answer, but this is where we will terminate as soon as we get something less than 0. Okay. Similarly, for 1, I'll go 0. 2, I go minus 1. And if 3, I get minus 2. What is the path? From here, I get 1, 1. From here, I get 1 and 2. From here, I get 1 and 3. Right? From here I get 2, 1. From here I get 2, 2. From here I get 2 and 3. We got answer from here and from here. Then I'll work with this one. So for this, I have 1, 2 and 3 steps. So 1, 2 and 3 steps. If I go 1 step, it will be 0. If I go 2 steps, it will be minus 1. And here it will be minus 2. So from here I get 1, 1, 1, and there's no need to write the paths for these two as it will be wrong anyway. So I have this as a path again. Let's check for, these will not work, okay? So wait, this is wrong. These are wrong. We are not going to work with them. This is also wrong and this is also wrong. So we are not going to work with them. So we got our answers that we have 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1 and 3 direct as our options for the number of jumps which we can take or the number of stair paths which we can have. Okay. So these will be our answers. This is what you have to do. Now let's work with it using coding. Okay. So what we need to do is, over here. We are taking a loop. My range is from 1 to 4. 4 will be exclusive, so it will only work for 1, 2 and 3. And we will call the function. We have this function over here. So we will call this function. Okay. And from question, how will it make changes? I will subtract I. Right. It will subtract 1, then it will subtract 2, then it will subtract 3. And to the answer, I will add I only. Right. Because I need to add 1, 2 and 3. Right. Okay. So, I hope this is clear. Then we'll work on the base cases. So, we have over here, if the value of question becomes less than 0, I will simply return, right? When we were getting minus 1, minus 2, I was simply returning. And if it becomes equal to 0, I will print my answer. It is ASF. Okay, over here also I will see. We need to give this also as string. Okay. So this was a mistake which I was making. Okay, now we print the answer so far and we go to the next line. Okay, and then we will return. So now let's try to run this. Okay, and we will submit it. And this is correct. Now we will do a quick dry run of this. Okay, so we will check our, this is what we have, right? Now I'll bring my code over here. Now let's work with it. Okay, so see, we were working from the third stair, right? So I will take for 1, then 2, then 3, right? So I went for 1. I got 2 over here, right? So question became 3 minus 1, that is 2. Then it started working for 2. So it got 2 minus 1, that is 1. Again I work for 1. Then I got 1 minus 1, that is 0. It became 0. So it will print the answer so far. In the answer so far, I was adding the value of I only but as string. So this is the path which I had maintained. I got my path. So I will print it and go down. Now again I came to 1. Again from 1 I will subtract. But now I will subtract 2 because the value of I was incremented. So from 1 I subtracted 2 and got minus 1. So question became less than 0. I will simply return. Then again from 1, now I will subtract 3. I got minus 2. It is less than 0. It will return. Right. So I got 2 now. From 2, now I will subtract 2. From 2, I had earlier subtracted 1. Right. Now from 2, I subtract 2. I get 0. So it will print the path and go back. Again, I get 2. I will subtract 3. It will give me minus 1. So it will simply return. Right. For 2, I am done now. For 3, I have subtracted 1. That is done. Now from 3, I will subtract 2. So it will give me 1. Right. From 1, I will subtract 1. It will give me 0. So it will print the path and return. Then from 1, I will subtract 2. It will give me minus 1. So it will simply return. From 1, I will subtract 3. It will give me minus 2. So it will simply return. We are done with this. Then from 3, I'll subtract 3. Right. So, I get 0. And I'll print the path and return. And we are done traversing the tree. So, we got our answers also. Over here, I have this, 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 and this as my answer, which we printed. So, this is how we solve the question print stair paths. I hope you understood the question as well as the solution. Thank you for watching the video. We'll see each other in the next video. Till then, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel.